bringing him over more, or is that just the way it is? Okay.
Well, yeah, you want to get him into position, unless you want to do this, man. Unless you want to line him up here and then rip and then load ropes.
Oh, okay.
And then get him back out here. You know, it just depends on how you going to face your offense. Are you going to motion every play? Or are you going to preset every play? Are you going to no huddle every play?
Okay. Gotcha.
Outside's a pretty good deal to just come out of the huddle and go outside.
Okay.
And just come up quick, snap the ball, and go.
No.
The reason against cover three, the reason that you'd rather run switch is because you can stack them in tighter, and you can just get that guy in there easier.
Mm-hmm.
But now,
see that.
Now what's going to happen here is, this guy's got to go up and over here now. It's cover three, so he doesn't have to go all the way in. That's not as bad. You know, but it's got to look something like that, you know. He's got to do something like that, and he wants to get off in there as quick as he can. All right, now, outside. It's just what it says. You got to keep these guys outside. Outside really doesn't have anything to do with the hashes. Okay, you're going to stretch here and go here. Now, read the over top coverage and sit down. You can sit down these guys right here. You can sit these guys down if you want. Just depends on how you want to pitch it.
Zone rule.
Yeah, but give them a 12 to 15 or 15 to 20, mm-hmm. You know.
Because
what will happen is the tendency for these guys is to take off down through there. Hey, I see him high over the top, and I'm going to set it down. And he's 5 to 7 yards down the freaking field, you know. But what he needs to do is push his top off the coverage there, and then set it down and come back for a passing lane. Okay, cover three. Again, you know, the 90-degree soft roll here. Here's the key. That guy right there. If you're going to load rows and get, you know, in a rip motion, and he comes back across the, he's going to bump a little bit. He's going to end up somewhere in the middle of the field. And here's what I tell the quarterback. On the fifth step right here, he wants to look at that guy real hard. He's reading this guy.
Yeah.
He's reading this guy on the fifth step. Now, if this guy right here takes a step in that direction, he knows he's going to throw the ball back over here. On that fifth step, he's going to look at that guy really hard, turn, and get the ball in the air to right there. Or if that corner falls off on that thing, he's going to get it outside. And, you know, if he doesn't like it, then he's still got this thing here. He's getting this kind of action, so he's not going to get this guy, you know, coming to the flats. He's going to get this guy's, you know, here for the, he's got the curl. You know, he's going to the middle of the field, and then we're trying to get.
All right, so that's cover three.
Cover three.
Super back.
Well, it's not necessary. What he's going to do is sit there and check. And, you know, I've got no threat on corner, so I'm going to sit here and then I'm going to check all the way back. I'm not going to go all the way back.
Yeah, just
I'm
like
just
going to
sit there and I'm going to look all the way back. But now on outside is a good time, especially in cover two, is to take him to the flats or to the middle. I mean, it's like outside B flat.
Yeah.
You know, B trail or B. You know.
Everybody go.
Yeah. It's just a game plan, whatever you decide to do with it. Okay, let's go cover two, and we'll cover man under at the same time. Let's don't motion right now. What we're going to say is here, we're going to quick snap, you know, outside.
Mm-hmm.
Put him on the hash. All right. It's not hard I mean, it's not hard right now to determine what kind of coverage we got. It's two. We know it's two, and we're not sure that it's two man. Now, we'll be pretty sure that it's two man if they've been given to us, you know, every time. Mm-hmm. But you'll know after the snap of the ball. Again, he's got to go outside. All right, now, here's the hitch on that thing. We're going to take these guys inside the hatch right here, just inside the hatch right there. He stays high on the top. We're going to set it down, bring it back across, look for the passing lane. Look for the passing lane. All right, now, there's two ways of looking at this thing. Are you going to give the play side... The play side slot, the option, or are you going to keep the top? Are you going to keep him pushing the top off the coverage? That's just what you got to make up your mind, because eventually what's going to happen here is you're going to have two people in the same area, especially if you get man under. Okay. But you don't run into that problem a whole lot. You push this guy. You try to get these guys to the inside of the hash to give these guys a chance to get deep. You want this guy to step over the hash. You'd like for him, you don't want him outside the hash so that he can defend like this. You want to have to make him conscious of catching the ball inside the hash. All right, five steps, look and see what happens. You got a guy here that's, let's say he's pushing a top off the coverage right now. Now you got a guy back here that's pushing. It's zone. You know, everybody's dropping to their zone. He's going to see zone. He's going to set it down and start looking for the passing lane back to the quarterback. Okay. Now, a lot of teams play this. Sprint to the field. You know, I'm going to roll and I'm going to back up. Mm-hmm. Well, when that happens, you might get this guy sitting down back over. Yeah, so when you start with that thing, you can still come back. Okay, now, man under. Okay, you got tail coverage. He starts his route. He's got coverage. He can't beat this guy deep. He can run all damn day. If he can beat him, he'll run. If he can't beat him deep, he's going to set it down, bring it across, and keep it moving. Same thing here. Set it down, keep it moving. And that's the only time that you'd really like to have that guy. Yeah, you'd like for him to push the top out off the coverage there. Let's go to 1-3. Okay. 1-3 outside and switch, which is, you know, turns out to be basically the same. The same deep. They'll give you a 1-3 blitz. And that's, you know, 1-3 is gonna look like 3. You know, if you'll motion, you know. And that's the reason, you know, that's a good thing about motion. And I'm doing everything 50 here. We can go to different fronts. Now, what's going to happen here, no matter what you're running, if you're running slide against 1-3, you're going to get a different arrangement of blitz. If you're in trips, you're going to get it from the backside. If you're in even, you're going to get it from the frontside guy. You know, that's the way they got to figure out how they're going to do it. You know, you'll have teams that come in there and they get trips, they got to call this blitz off, and they get something, they got to call this blitz off. But the teams that really do a good job, you know, you get trips over here that I'm coming off the backside. And that's when you got to do a good job of, if you got trips, you ain't got to worry about this guy. If you're even, this is the guy you got to worry about. So you really don't have a problem here. You can get some things like this, you know, working, but that's when you just got to do a good job, you know, here. And they won't hurt your backside. You know, this guy may have to step and come all the way back to this gap, you know, when he does this. Because he's going to end up the man, and he may have to flip around there and pick this guy up coming on this deal here. But at any rate, one free, you treat just like cover three, with the exception of, let's say he's threatening this deal, and he's got this guy, and he can't beat him, then he's going to sit it down and bring it across and keep it moving. Now, we want this guy to stretch it. Now, and we may get, you know, we may get this guy sitting down here, you know, depending on, you know, what the deal is. And he should sit it down over there, because if he ends up throwing this route, which can happen, you know, the deeper he gets down the field, the easier it is for this guy to come off. If he just keeps pushing and pays no attention to his downfield rule, then it just gives that corner an easier opportunity to fall off and come back on the deeper route. But if he's going to stay as deep as the deepest, which, you know, hell, in cover three, you're going to get wide as deep as the deepest. If he's going to stay as deep as the deepest, shit, that guy's open. You know, shit, I mean, he's just open. Same thing back here. Yeah. It's read. In cover three, in general, cover three, the slots are going to be running. And the outside guys are going to end up sitting it down. Cover two, it'll be the outside guys who are generally going to be the pushers. And the inside guys the sitting there. Going. Yeah, could. Depending on how you want to line it. Okay, blitz. Side or switch. You need some motion. Now, this doesn't always give you, that's not always going to tell you if this is to the field, whether it's going to be blitz or not. Let's say you got him right here, and he's just swinging back and forth. One thing that will tell you is that free safety right there. Because he's going to have to align himself. Now, if you take this guy and move him and bring him back, that'll give you a damn good indication of what's going to be blitz, because now he's going to have to do something here. See, yeah. If he comes back, if he crosses this hash right here, that's blitz. And if he's under the 9-yard limit back there. Mm-hmm. Right, so that'll give you blitz. Now, to the reaction to blitz movement, just check out that son of a bitch. You don't want to be in slot. Excuse me.
Oh, sorry.
You don't want to be an outside against the blitz. Or if you snap the ball, you got to throw it to this guy, you know, or to this guy, one or the other.
It'll still be a
deal. Right. Yeah. But what happens is, in this daggum thing, you know, somebody's got to take this guy. He's going to end up, you know, he's going to be rushing, and I'm going to block him. But somebody's got to take that guy, and it's usually this one. And when you get this guy here, cross his face, and you'll throw the ball on three steps, and he'll intercept the daggum thing. So you got to be careful about that.
You're just best to get the hell out of it.
Well, he's going to use it. You know, he's going downfield across your face. Yeah. Best thing to do is just have a blitz. Use your blitz package right there. You know, check the blues. You know.
Yeah.
Well, just 68.
Read.
New 69. Read. You know, check. Read. 63, whatever your blitz deal is.
Okay.
So just get out of it. Yeah. Versus blitz, it's just better to get out of it. You got a better deal. And you'll know, you know. And that's the reason that you generally
you gotta run
want this.
You
want
to consider.
Yeah. Now, in no huddle or pre-snap, let's say if you're in trips and you're trying to pick up blitz, that's good. Trips is good. You need to take this guy now and remove him. That's why, you know, in trips that you want to take you don't want to keep this guy too close, because now this guy can line up here and play man on him, and it still look like zone. But if you'll take him over here, put your trips out here, this guy's got to get over here. And when he does that, it's me. Mm-hmm. And shit, you know, what are they going to do? Bring him in here for the blitz and leave him in the middle of the field? They can't do it. They just raise up and get uncovered all day. So, the removal of this guy from the you know, from the formation has really helped, has really helped the recognition of, you know, of blitz. And in cover three against trips, this is the guy. That's the guy. Who's the key? Well, it's hard to tell on either a two back or an even offense. It's sometimes hard to tell. It's got to be this guy. He'll tell you. He'll tell you all the time. You ain't got to look at anything else. You don't have to look at the linebacker. You don't have to look at the way they're lined up. You know, that may be a good indication. But for the quarterback, that's the good one right there. And for these guys, too. You know, everybody can look at that guy and by his position know. And like even if you're running slide, we got slide call now. We don't have to say anything because he said, you know, this guy, hey, do you see what I see? You know, because this is man. I know now that I'm doing this, I'm running a bubble, and I'm poster fly.
That's right.
So it's, you can use that as an auto. It's self-adjusted rather than an auto. Mm-hmm.
Gotcha, Chief. That's outside.
Hey man, you can on the outside, and they're giving you a pretty steady diet of say man under or zone. You can use a fullback. That's good times to use your, you know, outside with your fullback in flats or you know, or on the drive or whatever. All right, what do we got?
We got a smash.
Smash.
It's John's favorite route.
Smash and outside, and I might mention that outside is a good middle of the field route. Outside.
It's like our everybody goes game.
Right? Yeah, outside, and just put middle. Okay. Field. You know, I drew that from the hash, but it's
pretty good.
Switch. I don't know if you want to run switch in the middle of the field. Switch is better from the hash.
Sure.
What are we working on?
Working on smash.
Okay, smash is a better middle of the field route.
We'll put it in the middle of it.
You know, you can run smash so many ways. You can run from trips, but hey man, let's just talk about it. And it doesn't matter if you just follow your rules. You just working the high and low, okay? And you know that's all smash is now. You got to remember that man under or one free, you know, you got to keep moving. You know, like when he sets it down here, he can't just relax and expect to, you know, the quarterback to read his man over high and low. Yeah, when he sets it down, he sees man pretty shit. He's coming. You know, he's coming. Man. And that's the difference. You can have it on both sides. You run.
So that'd be Y smash over
here. Yeah, you run X smash, which is bring your guy in, and then he runs.
That's right.
You know, he runs the deep. It's just, and you can run it from trips, and now you got this guy on, you know, on the drag. You know, he's on the hookup. So it's just a, you know, you smash is just a, you know, a concept. It's another high-low, ISO one guy. Yeah. It's good, really good against cover three. Mm-hmm. If you can get that corner, you know, to guess me, you know, we might. Picking on under guy, am I staying on top? And you usually stay on top. Hell, that's a great 8 to 12 yard.
I got cover two.
Well, you know, he just got the same thing here. If it's cover two, you know, what are you going to do? This guy's not going to be involved. And if he is, shit, the next thing he'll do is just, you know, post a flag. If he's going to get involved in that, which he's not. So you really don't have to worry about that. That's just like throwing a curl. Slide against the corner. Yeah.
That's right. Okay.
He's still going to read high enough here. Is he going to try to drop and defend the hole? If it is, shit. I mean, this is a gimme.
Pretty good.
And you got to throw a lot of those because your quarterback will screw that damn thing up to a bunch. And your receiver, he can't run to the sidelines and stop when you're coming across the field. You know, he needs to flex himself and bring himself in just a little bit. Because your strong safety now, he's going to be gone because he's got two vertical routes here.
How about blitz? Smash.
Well, blitz is that's another one of those deals when you ought to get out of smash. But it kind of, you know, what you want against blitz, this is not too bad. Smash is not too bad against blitz. if you had it, you know, if you had your receiver in tighter so that, you know, you don't have to throw the ball so far.
That's right. Yeah. You got to throw on three.
But the best thing to do against blitz is just check out it and run whatever. And you got you got an automatic. You just, you know, bingo, we got blitz coming. Now he just moves himself in, and it's an automatic, you know, either that or here. Right. You just don't want to run it. You want to bring him back in here so that you're not throwing the ball, you know, on blitz from here to here.
Oh, yeah. It's got to be gone.
I mean, you might want to throw it there, but you'd like to have this guy, rather than breaking from the hash over there, you'd rather have him breaking from the middle of the field. And you got to work that thing five step, you know. And, you know, against the blitz, of course, we're not talking about smash, but the blitz routes, you got to work off five steps, three, five quarterback, five to seven receiver.
Yeah, that's pretty good, then.
All right.
We did all the passing some routes.
Well, yeah, basically, we covered screens, didn't we?
Well, no, we're going to do that tomorrow.
Oh, okay.
Wednesday a little more. I mean, we've covered them, but it just. That's pretty good. And tomorrow we'll go option, dive, kick, draw, and they rumble there, John?
Yeah,
hey,
big,
hey, John.
Big weak side rumble.
Weak side rumble.
Let's block this thing.
Block,
I mean, I'm not testing you here. Let's just discuss it. I think there's probably two or three things you got to do. You think it's one protection, but it's really not. Okay, this is not the blitz. Okay. It's not the blitz, but they still might come. You got to defend the front.
Okay, we're going to protect those five, our five?
Mm-hmm.
What I would do?
Uh-huh.
Let me ask you a couple questions so I understand the big picture. Are you trying to stretch and break your hand, or are you trying to get to a point?
No, we're just trying to protect the core.
Are you trying to pull? You're not trying to break the chain.
No, we're coming here, and everybody's stepping to the play side. That's my guy. I step play side, and that's my guy. He drops, then I got a chance to come back side and help out here. Now, he's my guy, all right? I'm going to step, and that's my guy. He goes back side, I got it. I'm going to step, he's my guy.
What I would try to teach there, to me, the easiest guy, the easiest block on the field right there is the left tackle.
Yeah.
Okay, so what I would try to do is I would be real firm with this guy. I'd be real firm with the onside tackle on his play side foot, on his play side arm. And be almost like an aggressive reach, but in the reach block, we use the back hand. Here, I want to use the front hand. That's why I asked if we're going to set him up maybe
well,
five, six.
We don't want him on the corner.
Yes, sir.